Well, right now, Australia's national politics is still on a knife's edge. And today, it looks like one of the independent MPs who helped Julia Gillard stay in power, Andrew Wilkie, has had another victory. The Tasmanian MP claims he has legal advice that gives Canberra the power to override the states on one of his pet hates, gambling. Hello, our political editor Hugh Remington joins us from Canberra. Hugh, what's all that mean? What, has Andrew Wilkie had a win?
Well, he has indeed. It's always hard, of course, to do anything about gambling because the states, it's often said, are addicted to the gambling revenue, more than $5 billion just last year alone. But Andrew Wilkie, the independent, of course, made action on problem gambling a price of his support for the Gillard government when she desperately needed it in August of last year. And he forced Canberra to go and take legal advice to see whether the Commonwealth can force the states to take action on gambling. Here's what he said.
The Commonwealth has now received legal advice about its constitutional competence and that, as we all expected, the Commonwealth does have the power to intervene in problem gambling in the states.
Now, the prime target is pokie machines. More than half of all the gambling done in Australia is through those machines. Andrew Wilkie and others want a number of things. They want a system that will shut down a gambler once they've reached a predetermined amount of money going through a machine. They want a $250 limit on money on ATMs in gambling venues. And they also want warnings to turn up repeatedly on the machines while the gambler's playing.
Does that mean here that that this places the Gillard government in a bit of a cleft stick, to say the least of it? What can they do about this? Because they're caught between a rock and a rock.
Well, one thing you're not going to see is them suddenly wading into the states with a whole raft of new laws. They say they want to work with the states, but the Gillard government says it is completely sincere about doing something about problem gambling. Here's Jenny Macklin.
The government is very clear about our commitment to deal with problem gambling. We know that problem gambling ruins lives, and we intend to put in place serious reforms to deal with it.
Now, the obvious problem for Canberra, George, is that the minute you start dealing with states' revenues, the states start bleating for compensation. Now, Jenny Macklin says they're nowhere near having that conversation, but the one sure bet in all of this is that it is coming.